Robin? Huh? So there is a somebody who constantly speaks in your head.
Yeah.
Yes.
Huh? Shishir, you want to sit here? You can sit here. Put a chair. Put a chair. So how many people have this small little guy in their head?
Everybody is having it.
Who is this little guy? Who is this little guy? This is a society child. This is the society child sitting in your head, giving always constantly complaining, constantly giving problem. Okay? Now all your spiritual sadhana is to get rid of this fellow. Why you want to get rid of fellow? You remember your divine nature, you are free. Whatever a society child is coming there constantly telling you, these are like ghosts, no? Huh? Right? So what does this tell? Does it give some good advice anytime? Always say, what will happen? What will happen? See, what will happen? Always creating fear. Huh? Right? Anytime that child, society child comes and says, be peaceful, my dear, does he say? No. Always constantly creating fear in you. Because fear is a future. That's why it's ghost. So do you have such thing? Kumar, something in your head like that? But that's not you. That's the whole problem. You are confusing this me. That's the problem. You are the divine child, which is I, which has never changed. Why are you confusing with this guy who is coming and constantly telling you something? You are the one who knows that, who is aware of that. One who knows that, oh, there is a constant chattering going on in my head. Are you clear? Do you understand the difference? So this fellow is chattering fellow, he is the society child. Simple. Can you remove the society child?
No.
Huh?
No.
You don't have to. You don't have to. You have to remember your nature. I am the divine child. That's all. You don't have to remove the society child.
We can't remove also.
Don't need to. You have to remember your
society.
Divine child. Right? That's all. Nothing. You don't have to remove the society child. You don't have to struggle to remove the society child because it's too many. Okay? So now, what is the nature of this society child? You see, this is always creating fear. Stress. What will happen? Okay? Yeah, my health is not good. For whose health is not good? Which child?
Society.
No, it's a human child, biological child. Okay? The societal child will come and say, what will happen to you tomorrow? Huh? Kya hoga? Divine child is having pain. Okay, fine. The society child will say, what will happen to you tomorrow? Huh? Tomorrow you'll have to lie on the bed. Who will take care of you? Who will look after
you? Main question.
So, you have to understand, the society child will have always problem. The human child will always have a problem. You have to remember, I am not the society child, I am not the human child, I am the divine child. Okay, then you have to come to peace. Because you cannot repair, you can do little bit repair for the human child problem. You can do little bit repair for the society child problem, but it's all unrepairable. Got it? So what you have to remember? Nanu. Nanembudu. Nanalla. Ideha. Manabuddhi. Nanalla. Sachidanandatma. Shivananane. Shivoham. 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 So again and again you have to remember your divine nature. Don't try to, you do whatever is required for society child, little bit. You do what is required for human child. Okay, the society child will go, the human child will go, but divine child will never go, which is you. So now what you are doing, instead of addressing the divine child, you are addressing the society child and trying to solve the problem, which is never ending. Instead of addressing the divine child, instead of remembering the Baba inside you, you are trying to repair the human child. You can do a little bit repair, but you cannot fully repair it. It's human. How much repair you can do? One day it will become grow up old, become old and die. Right? Instead of that, recognize your true nature,
and become peaceful. That's called, that's the purpose of human life. That's all is the purpose of human life. Any questions? Are we clear? Are you able to see?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, now I'll tell you why this society child is coming here, picture. Right? Anybody has an idea why this society child is coming like this?
They have to live in society, no?
So what?
They
have to learn a lot. So what happens here? Yes, why the society child is coming is because of this reason. Just see. Can you see? What is going on?
What's inside?
See, your brain is a computer. Your brain is nothing but a computer. Okay? Understand? It's a machine. That means the human body is a machine with a computer. Proper? Understand? Now the computer can be programmed.
Yeah.
Okay? If you program a computer, it will do that job very well. Calculation, whatever is that.
Yeah.
True? Any program you run on the computer, it will do. Yes or no?
Yes.
And who all have programmed your computer in your head, you tell me? Huh? You started with your mother, father, TV, mobile, grandfather, friends, school teachers. Everybody has done nice programming of your computer. No wonder so many thoughts are coming. Huh? But are you that computer? You are the awareness of the computer. Are we clear? Huh? Are you living your life or your life is being lived by the society? You tell me. You are running these programs only. You are executing these programs only. Right? Huh? Your life, the purpose of your life is to come out of these programs and recognize that I am the divine child. That's all is the purpose. You understand? There are so many programs are running. Wonderful programs. Junk programs.
The program, good, bad, ugly, everything is
there. Everything is there. That society will, actually I initially told you, know, public toilet. Society is like, anybody can dump everything, you will dump on your head. Now when you say, I am unhappy, who is unhappy, tell me? This program, okay, it has nothing to do with you. I want enlightenment, who says so? I want liberation, who says so? The divine child is already peaceful and free, it has nothing, no problem with liberation. Huh? Where are your gods and puja coming from? Programs here. When God himself or you has come as you, the divine child, you are doing puja somewhere. Okay? And every day you are praying, God, save me, solve my problem. Whose problem you are solving?
Society.
Can the society problem be solved?
No.
Shri Krishna Paramatma came, Mahabharata war happened, Jesus Christ came, Buddha came. Huh? Society problem has been ever time solved?
Increased, in fact.
Increased, it will be like that only. So, whose problem you are trying to solve? You have a headache, you have a problem because you think you are getting messed up with this guy. Okay, you are confusing yourself with this guy. Try to understand your nature and be peaceful here. Why are you, how much problem, how many things you can solve? You go to a psychiatrist, right? Huh? And what the psychiatrist do? He also has a program in his head. Some program transfer happens. Exchange. Come on, understood? Huh? The human child, the body will have always problem. It will never be a day it will come. Some problem, leg problem, stomach problem, head problem, okay, old age problem, all problems will come. Okay? Some doctors can come and repair a little bit, but that problem will continue. The society child will always have a problem. Because it's a child of multiple fathers and multiple mothers. But what about you? Why you have a problem? The divine child has never a problem. You understand? Is this clear to all? Now you are living like this. You understand? What is this game? A robot, a machine programmed by the society. It's called bio boot. I am worried. I have a problem. Who has a problem? Society has a problem. My program is running and says, I am worried. Are you understanding?
Yes.
I have ambition. Whose ambition is that, sir? Programs. This is what you are actually. This is what is meant by spiritual. That's why Sri Krishna tells in Bhagavad Gita, human beings are running like machines. Okay? What do you call? Yantra. That time he said Yantra, like, okay, like machines you are running. This is what your machine, the robot concept he told in Bhagavad Gita itself. What, Shravan? So, please understand, all your dreams, all your suffering, all your pain, all your happiness, all your joys, all your likes and dislikes are from the society. And you are executing them, like a machine. You never had a problem. You understand? How does it make a difference in your life if you understand this? I am always peaceful. Right? No, I will do sadhana and become peaceful. Who will do sadhana, my dear? It's a society child. Will it become ever peaceful by doing sadhana? You have to recognize, that's what is jnana. Okay? Are you clear now? So, also you understand, let's just tell me some of the mistakes you have done in the past. Don't tell me exactly, I mean, you don't have to be very personal. Lot of mistakes we do in life and we regret I did a mistake. Okay? So, can you tell something? I got married is a common thing. I don't want that. That is common to all. That's other than generic, you can tell me something specific. Yes?
Engineering.
Oh, engineering is a mistake. Why engineering a mistake?
Then I wanted to go for BSc.
Accidental engineering. So, the past is about regrets. Right? Okay? So, the past is also about
guilt.
I should not have done this. Do you have guilt? Anybody has a guilt? Guilt is the next. Past is about guilt. The future is about?
Fear.
Future is always about fear. Okay? What will happen to me? Right? Future is about worries. I am worried too much here. What will happen to me tomorrow? So the future is about worries and past is about?
Regrets.
What is the present? Present is what?
Unsatisfactory.
Present is always peaceful. Okay? The future is about, past is about guilt, regret, grievances. That fellow did like this to me. I am like this because of that fellow, my friend, no? He put me into engineering. Okay? Sadness. Bitterness. And I don't forgive that fellow. Why the hell he put me in engineering? So this is about the past. Right? So all of you have this something? And what is about future? Uneasiness. Anxiety. Tension. Stress. Worry. Fear. So where are you actually most of the time? Please tell me.
Past
or future?
Past.
Past or
future?
Future. So there's funny thing about past and future, okay? If you ask a young boy, he doesn't have past. Young children, right?
Yeah.
He doesn't have future. He's always of the future. So one day, ek din hongi kamayav, I'll do this, I'll change the world, and all those things as a youngster. He has only future, right? He is always about the future, okay? Hope also is there. These are all negative things. Hope, I'll do this. Then, about the old man, what happened?
Only past.
He has dead end is over. He has runway is already over.
Yeah.
Okay, now he doesn't have a future. Yeah, you know, in my old day, when I was young, I used to get rice at 1 rupee per kg. Okay, if you ask old people, they always speak of the past. Okay, now come the middle age guys, 40 to 50. they are actually half life is over. Past is over, future is over. Okay, so now the past, all the hopes of the past is gone now. I'll change the world. Then they have realized that they can't even change the wife or children also. Okay, they come to middle stage. Right? Now the lot of the hopes and this thing have gone. The future doesn't look very bright also. So yeah, that's what it's called, midlife crisis. Heard of this? Midlife crisis. Many people take very serious spirituality when the midlife crisis comes. I'll be very serious spiritual. The moment he says I'm spiritual, then I understand. This guy is around 40, 45. Till that time, the childhood is well full of hopes. The old age is full of despair. So which category do you come in, my dear? Come to the present. Okay? Just get that over glass. Oh, that's the glass. Yeah, that one, yeah. Right? So, this is past. It's going into future. Okay? The past is continuously going into future. The present is one small moment. Right? Is that our life? Continuously mind is going into past to future. The mind's job is past to future. And mind is what? This program. Continuously past to future. The present is completely missed out. And the divine child is only present. It has no past or future. The society child has only past and future. The divine child has only present. So one day I'll get enlightened means who will say that? The divine child is, I am enlightened. This one day I'll get enlightened. When I say here and now, some people get angry. It is only speaking of theoretical. I'm not saying theoretical. The divine child is always here and now. When you are speaking of past and future, it's the society child. Society child will never get enlightened. Divine child is always in the present. So who has a problem?
Society.
So entire spirituality is to learn how to come back to the present. Live in the present moment, not in the future, not in the past. The future is for the society child. Past is for the society child or human child. Human child has also, tomorrow that the back pain will start. Okay? No, back pain should not start. What happened? My grandmother at the age of 60 had a back problem. Well, I have it. You will also have it. You will also have a leg problem also. Neck problem also. Okay, that's a human child problem. Right? But at any point of time, go back to the divine child, I, which is pure consciousness, peace. That's what is spirituality. Okay? What's wrong?
Shaker's question.
What is Shaker's question?
Okay, I'm in the present now. What to do?
So, What is society doing to you is, it is not allowing to you stay here. Okay? The moment you stay here, you are one with the God. It is so small, more narrow, you will miss it. Okay? Because the thoughts will come and overtake it. So you will miss this point. The spirituality or enlightenment is again and again come back here. So that now it looks like this, not like this. Continuously going from past to future, instead of that you are looking life like this. Where there is no past, no future. Is it possible no past and no future? For the divine child, yes. For society child, always past and future are there. For human child, there is a past and future. For the divine child, there is no past and future. Divine child is always now. So can you look like this? This is called spirituality. This is called enlightenment. This is called liberation. Possible? Not like this, not like this, but like this. How do you do that? If you don't do that, you are not living your life. Your life is being lived by the society. Your life is only here. Your life is always in the present, never in the past, never in the future. Actually, if you don't do this, if you are living like this, you are actually being lived as a robot. So when you go to a park, okay, your mind is full of mobile gadgets. Now you go to any bus and all, people will not your next person, they also they will do WhatsApp only communication. Okay, right? Within the house also, room to room communication is WhatsApp only.
Everyone.
Right? Head is full
of... No communication at all.
No communication. Head is full of everything. Whereas a child, mind is empty. Okay? The child is seeing the plants, sun. This guy is never seeing the sun or plant. When you go to the park, you have never seen a park in your life. At best, the moment you go to the park, you take a selfie. You don't even see park. The moment you see sun, selfie. You don't see the sun. I have gone to many tourist places. Everywhere people are
selfie.
They don't see, experience what they have come for. You miss the present moment. Selfie is for what? For the future. Are you living your life? My dear, living your life is called spirituality. Okay? And if you live your life fully in this moment, you are always so blissful. You say, anytime I am ready for death, I don't want death. If you are able to live any moment fully, you are full. Nothing more depending. Are you living life fully in this moment, like this, or constantly looking for something to happen? So now, what stops you from living life like this, horizontal? Tell me. You are actually constantly running after the society child, past and future. Whom are you doing like that? Huh? This is Baba. No past, no future, present. What's happening in the present is, that's all it is. Okay, now this is Baba. Baba, 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 please save me. Baba, save me. Society child. What happened to you? Baba said, my dear child, you are like this. No past, no future. The present. What's happening to you in the present? Nothing is happening. Tomorrow you may have a leg pain. Now also you may have a leg pain. At this moment, I am peaceful. I am the divine child. Again, they can go back to divine child. It is called spiritual life. Clear? So this is actually going to the past. Sorry, going to the future. The past. The past is so many things. Okay, it'll go to the future. The future will start becoming past. We are shuttling between the past and future like a robo. Come back to the present totally. Is it clear? That's all spirituality, that's all religion, nothing more. If you are able to live fully in the present moment, accepting life what has come to you, you are done. Your purpose of life is over. That's called Jivan Mukti. So you think something has happened to the Buddha and all? Nothing has happened. They aren't. They were running like this. Buddha was running like this for 6 years. Okay? Then one day realized, oh my God, let me live like this. That is called enlightenment. How to live like this? Again and again to come to the present. How to come to the present, I'll teach you now. Okay? So that you realize, I am that, I am, Shivoham, I am pure consciousness, Shiva Surapi, I am the divine child. That recognition you have to have. That divine child has gone nowhere, it's always there. When you say I, it's the divine child only. But you are confused with the society child, come back, drop the society child, come back to the divine child every moment. I'll teach you how. Okay? So we'll go for a break, few minutes break, and then continue. The past and future both are not there really. Past is gone, future is not there. The beauty of human child is always in the present. Human body is always in the present moment. For example, when you eat food, immediately there is a digestion will start happening. Okay, the heartbeat, if there is little bit stress, the immediately heartbeat rise. That means human body is always in the present moment. So the very simple practice, shift your attention from the society child to human child, over. Then you go back to the divine child. Shift your attention from the society child to the human child. Okay? Then you go back to the divine child. So let us do a practice now.